Do you want to rank up quicker? Do you want to play a hero that is so freaking overpowered? In the current rank scenario, we have seen him getting banned in almost every third game. Yes, that's how powerful and easy to play Armin is. His skills and passive might sound complicated, but trust me, it will be more exciting after trying it out in game. Hi guys, Kazuki here, and in this video, we will explain Armin in the simplest terms. Before starting, we want to let you guys know that we appreciate your presence and we love the way you guys keep supporting us. Many of you guys showered us with your love on Kazuki Official Gaming channel. We also want to inform you about the upcoming giveaway of 30 epic skins on 100k subscriber. We already at almost 60k subscriber and only 40k subscriber more to go on our second channel, Kazuki Official Gaming. To participate in the giveaway, like the video, subscribe to the channel and comment down anything regarding the video. And with that, welcome to the first episode of our new series Play Like Pro Guide, PLPG. In this episode, we will tell you how to stack and manage Armin's passive, when to use his skill combos, how to rotate his builds, emblem and most importantly his counters. Let's start with his passive. Hitting enemies or minions with his skill will make him go invisible, during which he will regen HP and movement speed while being invisible. There will be an indicator below. Here is a side-by-side comparison. The best part of being invisible is that he cannot be targeted by target log skills. Also, his basic attacks get enhanced after activating his passive. You can see the shards getting stacked after being invisible. This is where Armin's main damage comes from. While being invisible, his passive shards will start stacking and enhance his basic attack range and damage. Using basic attacks while being invisible will make him jump to the nearest target and deal damage. Enhanced basic attacks will also reduce the cooldown of all his skills by 0.5 seconds and stack one shard per basic attack at a time. His first ability is a target lock skill, which deals a small amount of damage to a single target. After successfully hitting a target with this skill, he activates his passive. With a full stack of shards, if he uses this ability, the stacked shard will also fly to the target to deal damage. These shards will later fall on the ground after dealing damage. His second ability has a boomerang effect. He throws a shard in a designated direction, which returns after a short delay. After getting the shards, he can again activate his passive. If an enemy is hit by this ability, the shards will instantly return to Armin and the enemy will be slowed down when hit by this ability. Here is a side-by-side comparison. On maximum stack of shards, the shards will fly to the hero and deal damage accordingly, then later fall on the ground. The ultimate, on the other hand, is like Gushen's second ability. On using it, he will mark an enemy hero and throw all the shards towards it. The fallen shard that was stacked on the ground before will further maximize the damage dealt. This ability will deal maximum damage if the remaining HP of the target is below 30%. Here is a side-by-side comparison. In conclusion, just remember his abilities are mostly to activate and stack up his passive skills. You can try this build. Arcane Boots for magic penetration. Feather of Heaven for a faster basic attack. Shadow Twin Blades for instant burst basic attack to combo with his passive. Calamity Reaper for the extra 2 damage. Genius Wand for magic defense reduction. And Winter Truncheon, or you can choose any suitable defensive item. You can also try this emblem set for maximum damage output. We recommend you guys use Aman as a jungler. So for spell, use Retribution. Unlock his skill 1 at first and go for the blue buff. Then go for the red. After that, prioritize the lane which has the turtle or the lane which has the weakest side laner. Turtle buff will help him a lot since he needs to get close and deal damage to the enemies. His damage is based on his passive and basic attacks, so we recommend using him like Natalia. Use your second ability to hide, follow up and ambush the target when he is off guard, which will also give time to stack his passive shards. Then use the first ability with an enhanced basic attack, finish the rest of the combo with his ultimate. Tips and tricks. Whenever there is a gank, you can quickly use the second ability to sneak on the enemy backline and deal maximum damage to the squishy core. On low HP, use your second ability to escape from your enemies and regen your HP. Since with his passive, enemies will not be able to target him by target lock skill, he will also increase movement speed at the same time. You can also use your ultimate on jungle monsters to farm fast. Use your passive to your best advantage by stacking the shards on the ground, so that if there is a gank, you can use the shards on the ground to use your ultimate with maximum damage. Let me give you an example. Here I was attacking the turtle when my team initiating the gank. As you guys can see, while attacking the turtle, many of the shards of my passive fell and gathered on the ground. After which, when I used my ultimate on Yuzhong, the shards went flying towards Yuzhong. The ultimate's damage drastically increased and maximized the damage output, which led to killing Yuzhong in the process. Remember, he is an assassin, and even he got burst damage, he is not built to sustain other burst damages. He can easily be burst down. CC skills are hard counter for him. If you are using a tank, then go for a radiant armor. Since tanks are more sustainable and high HP hero, they can sustain and stack up the radiant armor's passive and minimize Aman's damage. If you are using a mage or marksman, it's better to go for Athena's shield. It will help you to defend against Aman's instant burst. That will be it for the Aman's guide. Was it helpful for you guys to understand or counter Aman? Do comment below which hero has been troubling you recently so that we can make a guide for that hero. Thank you guys for watching and keep supporting Kazuki Official.